The local average treatment effect is defined when the instrument and the treatment are both binary variables. That means they can take on two different values. For example, suppose we're looking at the effect of education on wages. And in our data set, we have a variable that says whether someone went to college or not, and another variable that says whether there was a college in that person's hometown or not. Well, that's a case where the local average treatment effect is defined. And this is very common in practice, having a binary instrument and a binary treatment. Now, in general, when we have treatments or instruments that take on more than just two values, instrumental variables analysis will still apply, but things get a little bit more complicated. So we're not going to look at that. Instead, we'll focus on just the binary treatment and binary instrument case, where we're going to be able to learn all of the main ideas and all the intuition. So, in particular, I'm going to look at the application to randomized experiments with non-compliance. That's a very helpful setting for understanding how the local average treatment effect is defined. Now remember that in this case, our instrument is treatment assignment, whether you are assigned to receive treatment or not. That treatment assignment is an instrument for actually receiving treatment. Because there's non-compliance, people who are assigned to get treated don't necessarily get treated. Okay? So that's the setup we're in. Now, what we're going to do is take our population of people and split them into four distinct types, depending on how they react to their treatment assignment. The first group is called always takers. These people always receive treatment, regardless of whether they were assigned to. So that is, regardless of their instrument value, they always get treatment. The second group are called never takers. These people never get treated, regardless of their treatment assignment. The third group are called compliers. These people receive treatment if and only if they're assigned to the treatment group. So they comply with their treatment assignment. That's why we call them compliers. The fourth and final group are called defiers. They get treated if and only if they're not assigned to the treatment group. So they do not comply with their treatment assignment. They instead defy their treatment assignment. So every single person can be put in one of these four groups. So now we can define the local average treatment effect. It's just the average of the unit level causal effects for the compliers. So we've got our population. We take our compliers and we put them over here. Then our defiers, our never takers, and our always takers, we just put them over here and ignore them for now. Among our compliers, each person has a unit level causal effect, so we just take the average of all of those numbers for those people. That's all that the local average treatment effect is. So it's very similar to the average treatment on the treated and the conditional average treatment effect. Those also were just average treatment effects for a subset of units from the whole population. The average treatment on the treated was just the average unit level causal effect for the people who were treated. And the conditional average treatment effect, for example, for men, was just the average unit level causal effect only for the men. So the local average treatment effect is very similar. It's just the average of the unit level causal effect for the compliers. Now, one thing that makes this a little bit more complicated than CATE and ATT, treatment on the treated, is that from our data, we don't actually know who the compliers are. Okay, so for the conditional average treatment effect, we know who the men are in our data set. And for average treatment on the treated, we know who the people who are treated are in our data set. But compliers, we don't know who they are. And that's because the definition of what makes somebody a complier depends on two potential outcomes. It depends on what they would do if they were assigned to be treated, and what they would do if they were assigned not to be treated. And because of the fundamental problem of causal inference, we can never observe both of these potential outcomes at the same time. Because for each person, we either assigned them to be treated or assigned them not to be treated. We can't have it both. So we just don't know who is and who isn't a complier. So that makes sort of conceptually thinking about the local average treatment effect a little bit harder, because these groups, this particular subset of people we're looking at, is a little more complicated than just thinking about the set of men or the set of people who were treated. But it's still the same fundamental idea, an average unit level causal effect for a particular kind of people. And another place that it makes it more difficult is how do we even learn the local average treatment effect from the data if we don't know who's a complier in our data set? Well, to answer that, we'll do that in another module.